Next, let's go ahead and add some navigation hotspots. Go ahead and orient your picture to where you want to place your hotspot. In this case, we're going to go down the hill. Then go over to Hotspots Properties, click it, and you can open up the menu here and go ahead and choose Icons. From there, you can select a font library. I'm going to make this bigger for you. There you go. And just choose one of the fonts that they have here for your graphics. You can, through trial and error, choose what you like. I like Font Awesome, so let's start with that. Type in what you're looking for here. You can see they have many, many different kinds here, but we're going to just go with a nice standard, maybe boring, arrow. Now remember, every font has its own library. So choose what you like. These are my favorites. Click and drag that into your photo. You can see that Theasys will try to put that there. Now you'll notice a red outline wireframe around it. That means that you're not linked to anything. Let's go ahead and link you to the next picture. All right, so scrolling down, you can see now you have a hotspot. You have basic or font icon options. That's where we can adjust colors and other things. We'll do that in a minute. First, we have to decide what we want this hotspot to do. You can see by clicking on Action that there are many, many different things that you could do. We're going to link it to our next panorama. This will pop up a window here. What you need to do is tell that window what you want to link to. You can do that by choosing your picture, clicking, and dragging it into the box. Now you'll notice that the wireframe around the arrow turned green. You'll also see a dotted line around the chosen picture. You can close the window by doing that. Next, let's go ahead then and adjust our icon just a little bit. And this is the fun thing. You have patch to panorama, which is the default. You can see that it will make your arrow or your icon distort. If you don't want to do that, you can face to camera, where it will always be straight. Let's go ahead and have this one match the panorama. It's always a little more fun. Down below, this is where you can adjust what the arrow is pointing to. So you can see I want it to go forward just a little bit like that, but moving the X. Y, we'll adjust the tilt. We don't like that. Let's go back. So you can go back here, click, and use your arrow buttons to adjust your angles to get it just right. Or Z. Z will rotate it. Give all three a try, all right? Opacity just means how visible you want it to be. And a little bit is always nice to let your viewers look through it. Now, scale is simply how big. So there you go. Let's make it a little bit bigger, and that's nice. Now, after that, that's great. So far, it's looking pretty good here. But it might be better with a shadow. For that, go to Font Icon Options, and then you can kind of see here. There are many different selections, many different ways you can do this. This is the easiest way. So we're going to give it a visible shadow, and then just like we adjusted before, by playing with the X, Y, and Z dials, you can adjust your shadow. Now let's go ahead and give it here. Spread means blurry, how blurry it looks on the edge, how natural it is. After that, we'll give it a little bit of this there. And that looks pretty good. Okay, if you want to test, you go ahead then. From that point on, you can click on it with your mouse, or you can hit your space bar, and that will jump you to the next image.